Marcus Miller has been in touch to ask us how you highlight smooth, muscular arms. And to do this, first of all, what you need to do is base coat, shade, and layer the skin in preparation for it. So for our example, we're going to base coat with Bugman's Glow, then shade with Reichland Flesh Shade, and then layer using Cadian Flesh Tone. Now after that, we're going to highlight it with Kislev Flesh. But first of all, we're going to glaze it onto the arm for a soft highlight. Then we're going to finish off with a sharp highlight, again, of Kislev Flesh. But first of all, we need to base coat using Bugman's Glow, and I'm going to apply this with a medium layer brush. And what you want to do is get the paint thinned down in your palette, and you want this whole effect to be as smooth as possible here. So it is important you thin your paint down to about this sort of consistency before you start to apply it. Now, for our example, we've got a Slaughter Priest here because you can see the pose is perfect for showing what we're doing here. I'm going to focus on just painting this arm here, but you can do this, of course, on any part of skin that you want to paint. And with this colour, you will need to apply two thin coats. Next, shade all over the skin with Reichland Flesh Shade, being sure it settles nicely in all the recessed detail. Once the shade's completely dry, you're ready to add your layer of Cadian Flesh Tone, and here you want to avoid the recessed areas where the shade settled the most. So you see I'm just being really careful here, following the muscles and the raised areas like this. And again, you'll need to apply two thin coats and keep it as smooth as possible. Once you've reached this point, you're ready to add that glaze of Kislev Flesh. And to do this, what you need is a small airbrush now, and we're going to use a palette to make this. You just want to get a small amount of the paint there onto your palette and then add lots of water to it. So you want to really thin it down to about that sort of consistency there. And then make sure you're not applying too much of it at once. So just use some tissue to get rid of the excess off your brush and just get a small amount loaded up on there. And then what we're going to do is paint this onto the areas where the light would land, on towards the top of the arms and the muscles. So you're looking at this one, for example. I'm just going to paint towards the top of it a thin coat like this. So as it dries, we really take advantage of that transparent nature of layer paints and get a really soft highlight appearing on top of that muscle there. Now that's dry, you can see we built up a nice soft highlight, and we're ready just to finish it off with a sharp highlight, so still with Kislev Flesh, this time not diluted as much. I'm just going to add a line highlight just at the very top of each of these muscles where we've been building up the colour previously. And here we have the completed effect. Now you could take it a little bit further if you wanted to by glazing and highlighting using Flayed One Flesh, but whether you do or not, of course, is entirely up to you. So Marcus, I really hope that's answered your question, and we'll see you all again soon.